નમસ્કાર દર્શક મિત્રો, ફરી એક વખત આઈસીટી કો ફોર યુ ચેનલ આપ સર્વને નવી માહિતી પીરસવા જઈ રહી છે. વેલકમ ઓલ વ્યુઅર્સ ઇન આઈસીટી ઇકો ફોર યુટ્યુબ ચેનલ. આપ સર્વનો હું ખૂબ ખૂબ આભારી છું. આપ સર્વે ચેનલને સબસ્ક્રાઈબ કરી છે, નિત નવી માહિતી મેળવી રહ્યા છો અને માહિતી પોતાની પૂરતી ન રાખતા આ ચેનલને જેમ બને તેમ આપના ગ્રુપમાં સબસ્ક્રાઈબ કરી સામાજિક ભણતરની દિશામાં આપ પણ પોતાનું યોગદાન આપો. સબસ્ક્રાઈબ કરી, લાઇક કરી, શેર કરી આ ચેનલ દરેકે દરેક શૈક્ષણિક રસિકોને આ ચેનલોની માહિતી પૂરી પાડો. તો આવો આ ચેનલમાં વેલકમ ઓલ ઓફ યુ. આજનો આપણો જે વિષય છે તે ધોરણ 11 ચેપ્ટર નંબર 5 કોસ્ટ ઓફ પ્રોડક્શન. સો વેલકમ ઓલ વ્યુઅર્સ ઇન આઈસીડી કો ફોર યુટ્યુબ ચેનલ. Today's my lesson is cost of production. So I hope you know what's about this channel. So cost of production, very important chapter for standard 11. In this chapter introduction are there. As there is a change in the quantity of a production, there is a change in the total cost. By cost we come to know the debit side and revenue, we come to know the credit side of the firm. So expenditure and revenue is the part of the firm. If cost are higher than revenue, we are in loss, and revenue is higher than cost, we are in profit. So this chapter is very important. The part of various cost, various revenue, how it calculate, what are the formula. Cost and revenue determines the normal production level. Here how it help us. So first point is it help firm to decide price, provides guideline to expend maximum profit, to understand the behavior of firm. It plays an important role in taking decision, to make the decision very easily and clearly with the help of cost and production. Sixth, to know the alternative uses is useful to give guideline for the administration. So these are the introduction point, very important. Now second point is various concept of this chapter. First is real cost. According to Marshall, the laborer, capitalist, entrepreneur who are involved in the process of production, they do mental and physical work. Entire economy activity are basic on these two, because they all are their physical works, their mental works. So according to Marshall, the laborer, capitalist and the entrepreneur who are involved in the process of production bear psychological and physical burden. Such burden is called real cost. Real cost cannot be present in monetary terms. Therefore, real cost is also known as a non-monetary cost. Very important. This one is real cost is another name with non-monetary cost, because the laborers psychological and physical burden cannot be evaluated in terms of money. So Professor Marshall says that the factor of the production phase is real cost and attract them return is given in the form of wages, interest and profit. Now second is opportunity cost. Very important this one for the some MCQ and one sentence line. The concept of the opportunity cost was presented by Austrian economist, but it was properly presented by Marshall. Keep in mind that it is represented by the Austrian economist, but properly presented by Marshall. This concept is based on the particular characteristics of factors of production when a factor is used for a particular use. The other use is left out, or the same cannot be used for the other purpose. There is the best alternative which one is left. It is called opportunity cost. That means if there is two alternative and we are not getting both at a time and we have to left down for the one and we miss this and we lost, that is our opportunity cost. So we have to put down some other opportunity. Problem in measurement of opportunity cost. Factor with one use. If factor of a production has only one use, then it is opportunity cost cannot be decided. For example, some piece of the land is used only to produce grass. So far as that piece of land, opportunity cost cannot be calculated. Means if there is only some piece of the land is used only to the produce grass, so far as that piece of the land, opportunity cost cannot be calculated. So this is the problems in measuring opportunity cost. Second problem is that factor having specific use. If factors of the production are specific factors, then this concept is not useful. Returns are decided on basis of their demand. For example, persons having X price over the computer, etc. So factors having specific use are also problem of measuring opportunity cost. If some of the person are in expertise in some work, they are not going to some other works. So this type of person having expertise over computers or others, they are not facing this type of opportunity cost problem. So problem in measuring opportunity cost is two. First is from factor with one use. Second is factors having specific use. Now third one is monetary cost. Concept of the monetary cost is very easy and very useful in economic analysis decision and related to the production and in price determinations. Cost of production is calculated in terms of money. Therefore, concept of monetary cost is important. The cost of production in terms of money is known as a monetary cost. For example, if a factory produced pen incurred the cost of the 50,000, they produce 1,000 unit of pen. So the monetary cost of the production is 1,000 unit of pen is rupees 50,000. So here very clear, if any commodity which are evaluated by some of the price or some of the rewards, it's all are known as a monetary cost. So if the presence of some currency for the production or service, it is called monetary cost. This concept is very important for the one sentence or MCQ. Now short term and long term are also important part to recognize our cost of production. According to time period also is short term monetary cost is prepared. Raw material, extra laborers, fuel are those factors which can be changed in short period. Therefore they are known as a variable factors. Very important in short term, for example 1 year, 2 years, we can change raw materials or we can input some of the extra labor. If there is a season of some festival and demanding of some of the production, so we can put extra labor in short period. Fuel, those are the factors can be changed in a short period. On the other hand, machinery, building, factory, etc. cannot be changed in short period of time. Therefore they are known as a long term. It is called fixed factor of production. And above the raw material, these all are it is variable factors, and this one is fixed factors. Why? Because it will be changing after a long time. But here raw material, extra laborers, we can easily change. So it is called variable. It is changeable. But these all are machinery, building. If we want to renovate our factory, if we want to purchase other machinery, it will not easy in a short term. So it is all are as a fixed factor production. Now short term. A short term in a such a period in which a producer cannot be changed the size of firm can increase production by use of factors of production capacity. Here certain factors of the production are fixed. For example, plant, heavy machinery, etc. These all are not be changed in short time, but a short term is a such period in which producer cannot be changed the size form, but can increase production with the help of some laborers, with help of some new techniques, and in short term they can increase their production capacity. So here certain factor of production are fixed, for example building, etc. They are not very easily converted in short period. Long term is such a period in which a producer can change all the factors of production. In period of the factors of production are variable, for example plant, heavy machinery, building of the factory. Production can change the size of the firm, and doing so he can change the total production to long extent in the long term. So in this second point of the long term, producer can change so many. They can renovate their factory, they can rebuy some repurchase of the some plant, heavy machinery, but it will take time. In a short time, one or two years, they are not supposed to buy very easily this type of heavy machinery and building, etc. So it will take time. So it's called long term. Now very important classification of the production cost. It is very important. There are two types of short run production and long run production types are there. In their fixed cost, variable cost, average fixed cost, average variable cost are there. Now we are going to in deep. Fixed cost. It is very easy and very understandable definition of that fixed cost. It's in short term period, either production increase, decrease or remain zero. The cost is remain fixed, no change. It remain constant. There is no change in production cost. That types of cost is known as a fixed cost. It is also known as overhead cost. Very important. This another name of this cost is overhead cost. Fixed cost is also known as overhead cost. It is also known as a total fixed cost. So fixed cost or total fixed cost or overhead cost are similar words. Total fixed cost curve is parallel to x-axis. Very very important for MCQ or one sentence standard of standard 11 standard students, keep in mind that total fixed cost curve are parallel to x-axis, that we keep in later on. But here the definition of fixed cost, for example premium of life insurance corporation, premium of fire insurance, they all are fixed. There is production are in factory or not, if plus or minus, it not be changed. It is called fixed cost. Now second is variable cost. When cost incurred on variable factors by producer is called variable cost. Increase in the production, cost will be increased. Decrease in the production, cost will be decreased. Production is zero, cost is zero. This is known as a variable cost. It is also known as unstable or direct or main cost. Keep in mind that it is another name of variable cost is unstable or direct or main cost. In short term, fixed cost is fixed, but variable cost keep changing. Keep in mind this very 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 important this one. In short term, fixed cost is fixed, but variable cost keep changing. Professor Marshall has said variable cost is a main cost. So here in variable cost, there are direct relationship between production and cost. If the production is increased, cost will be increased. If the production is decreased, cost will be decreased. So here, keep in mind that if the production is zero, there is no possibility of increase or decrease in cost. In fixed cost, if the production are zero, even there are same no change in the fixed cost. So this is the difference between these two is very important. Total cost. Word total itself says some of the definition of its total. That means total of fixed and total of variable. There is causes relationship between total production and total cost. Total production more, total cost is more. Sum of the total fixed cost and total variable cost is equal to total cost. So the sum up of the total of fixed and total of variable is known as a total cost. So here TFC stand for total fixed cost, TVC stand for total variable cost, and together that is called total fixed cost. Variable cost increase, total cost initially increase. So TC and TVC are parallel to each other, very very important. Now average fixed cost. Average, that is division between something, that is called average. So average fixed cost is cost of per unit output, very very important, per unit output is also known as the average fixed cost. Average fixed cost equal to total fixed cost divided by total production unit. This is very very important example, sorry, very very important formula for getting 1 marks or in MCQ. Total fixed cost equal to total fixed cost divided by total production. Average fixed cost decrease as output increases. It means that average fixed cost curve is having left to right, upwards to downward slope. Average fixed cost decrease but never becomes zero. It is because of this fixed cost. If fixed cost, then production are zero or plus or minus, even it is zero, even it is fixed. So there is no possibility average cost become a zero. So this is very important for you all. Now I like to ask you one question. As we revise, you have to mention this question in your comment box, or you have to keep in mind that how it write in exam. So first question is, what is monetary cost? Who represent average cost? Or Austrian economics represent which cost? So you have to given this answer in comment box. Now next point is average variable cost. As we see here, in average fixed cost there is a total fixed divided by total production unit. So here in average variable cost we can find out here total variable cost divided by total production. So average variable cost, total variable cost of the firm divided by the total unit of produced, we get average variable cost. This concept is useful to taking decision regarding continuous production, increasing production or closing down. Average cost will help the producer in taking this type of decision. So average variable cost equal to total variable cost divided by total production. Very very important formula for getting 1 marks in section B or section A. Average cost equal to total cost by dash, that is total production, or average cost equal to dash by total production, that is total variable cost. It has negative stock curve. So these two average cost are finished here. Now next is average cost. Average cost in terms of total average cost is also known as average fixed cost. Average cost is cost per unit of production. Average cost is found by dividing total cost by unit of production. Very important for the definition of average cost is, average cost is found by dividing total cost by units of production. Total cost is the sum of the total fixed cost and total variable cost. Very very important formula is that total cost, total cost in terms of fixed plus variable together divided by total production, it is called average cost. Now this is very important for the MCQ in one sentence. Average cost curve is dash F, that is U, that we discuss later on. But how it comes U and how it is procedure, it is dependent on our fixed and variable cost. Why? Because fixed cost is fixed at any level of production, but variable costs are divided and increase and decrease by the production. So it is called USEP. Now there is some summarize of these units. There are some question answer are there. Concept of revenue help firm to decide dash of the commodity price. Concept of dash is useful to guideline for the administrator of the firm, that is monetary, to produce any goods and services, whatever the expenditure is incurred in, known as a cost of production. Concept of real cost is given by dash, that is classical economist. Some other are also there, putting burden, pain, sacrifice, annexity are the including, that is called real cost. It never be measured in monetary value. Then the cost of unborn and unproduced commodity is dash of the produced commodity, that is called opportunity cost. Return of the factors having specific use is decided on the basis of dash, the demand. In monetary cost, the production is decided in the terms of money. Now second cost is, we completed fixed cost, average fixed cost, variable cost, average variable cost, total cost and total variable cost. Now new concept is that marginal cost. Marginal, that is something adding. Whatever changes take place in total cost, none is a marginal cost. Marginal cost is change in the total cost. when an additional unit of output is produced by the difference of units of production cost and one unit of production cost, we get marginal cost. Marginal cost equal to TC n minus 1. Marginal cost curve is likely hockey stick. So here, if total cost is 100 at the level of one unit and total cost increased by 50 and come 150 by unit second, so difference is between 100 and 150, that is called 50, it is called marginal cost. If 150 by 200, 200 by 300, then addition of the sum of the total cost due to some of the additional of extra excess of our production, the gap between total cost, it is called marginal cost. Now, interrelationship between average cost and marginal cost. Average cost, that is division between total cost and production, and marginal cost is the difference is between total cost due to production of unit. The relationship between the average cost and the marginal cost hold an important place in production cost. Cost per unit of output is called average cost, and the marginal cost is the cost increased to produce one extra unit of the commodity. As output increase, initially the average cost and the marginal cost decrease. So here, three type of relationship are there. Marginal cost less than average cost. Average cost always higher than marginal cost. Initially the average cost decrease, then the marginal cost decreases. But marginal cost decreases more rapidly. The curve remain below average cost curve. Always keep in mind that the curve remain always below the average cost. Why? Because average cost are higher than marginal cost. Average cost depend on total cost. Total cost depend on fixed and variable cost. So this cost is always higher than marginal cost, because marginal cost is a sum of the differences between the total cost after putting one extra unit of production. Second interrelationship between these two. Marginal cost equal to average cost, sometimes MC equal to AC. So when average cost is minimum at that time, marginal cost curve intersect to average cost, intersect to the average cost curve from below, and the marginal cost and average cost become equal. So at that time, intersection point of the MC and AC is the second relationship between these two. And now third is marginal cost may be higher than average cost. Third relationship, when marginal cost curve intersect the average curve, then both costs start to increase. And in same way, some of the long term period when renovation are there, some other factors are there, building and production methods are totally changed, then total cost remain fastly growing up. Why? Because all fixed cost will remain in variable mode. So marginal cost will be increased and average cost are decreased. So there are three important relationship between marginal and average cost. Long run average cost curve. According to the Benham, very important, this economist, the name is very important for MCQ one sentence. According to the Benham, in long run, there is no distinctions between fixed cost and variable cost. In order to increase production, in long run, factors of the production can be altered in any proportion. Therefore, the scale of the firm expand. Thus, factors which are fixed in short run become variable in the long run. So some of the costs are sometime is fixed, but long time it will be variable. Now, concept of the revenue. So costing part is over here. One question is there: how many costs are there? Give their name. What are the formula of fixed average fixed cost? Third, what are the formula of marginal cost? You have to comment on in comment box. Please subscribe this channel so that you can easily find out so many videos regarding this. Okay, now the another concept is concept of revenue. In capitalist market structure, the main objective of the production is known as a maximize their profit. Every business person wants profit and get maximum profit. Therefore, a concept of production is also on profit. Therefore, the concept of revenue is very, very important significance. While analysis profits in short run, the concept of average revenue and margin revenue are used are more often. So, first is total revenue. Here, total, that is total income, and total income is depend on sold unit and their price. By selling of production, unit money received by firm is known as revenue. The producer, whatever they sell in the market, service or production, are sell, then they earn money. Total income received by the firm from the sale is called total revenue. Very important definition. Total income received by the firm from the sale is called revenue. Very easy. If we buy, if we sell some of the commodity, right, potato or some of the other television or some of the some durable commodity, right, mobile, and we received some of the income, that is called revenue. It is also known as their sale revenue. Firm's total income is based on two things: price per unit and total sales. So here very important, and for exam, total revenue formula: unit sold into price of commodity. If you sold 20 mobile at the rate of 10,000, so 20 into 10, the multiplication of these two, it is called total revenue. So first concept is total revenue here. Now second is average revenue. Average, that means sum of the division. We find out average revenue of a firm by dividing total revenue to sale unit. Very, very important this, dividing of total revenue to sale unit. Here the formula is very important: total revenue divided by total sale. Average revenue by the angle of producer is also price of consumer angle. So average is very important. If the total in revenue of selling is higher, then average revenue must be higher. Now margin revenue. Marginal revenue is revenue from the sale of one additional unit. So the margin revenue is the change in the total revenue which resulted from the sale of one more units of commodity. The margin revenue is change in the total revenue on account of the sale of additional units of output. MRN equal to RN minus RN minus 1. So here marginal revenue means if producer sell 100 units and received 1000 rupees, and after that they received 1050 rupees of extra unit of selling, then the gap between total revenue 1000 and 1050, so 1050 minus 1000, it is called 50, it is called margin revenue. So gap between total revenue due to one of the reason of selling extra unit, it is called marginal revenue. Total revenue, average revenue and marginal revenue under perfect competition market. What is perfect competition? What is characteristics of perfect competition? That we learn in next video of chapter number 6 market. But here, perfectly competitive market is such a market where firm accept market price and sell its commodity. Perfectly competitive market is a such market where firm accept market price. Firm have to accept so that they can stay in the market and sell their commodity. Commodities are homogeneous and there are large number of buyers and sellers. Here price is fixed and constant. Very, very important. These characteristics of perfect competitive market is high. Here price is fixed. There is no plus, no minus, no ups, no downs in the market. So this type of market is one of the hypothetical market, not real market. Price never be fixed, but here one assumption is there: price is fixed and constant. In perfect competition market, price equal to what? AR, average revenue, equal to MR, that is called margin revenue. So price equal to average revenue equal to MR. In short, P equal to AR equal to MR. So in competitive market, perfect competitive market, price are equal. So price are equal, then if the price is 10, we solve one unit of that, so total revenue 10 into 1, 10. And margin revenue, total revenue by total sale, so 10 divided by 1, it is also 10. So here price is 10, average revenue is 10, and margin revenue also 10. Total revenue, average revenue and margin revenue under imperfect competition. In this slide we see the perfect competitive market, but here same three category in imperfect competition. A situation where perfect competition is absent, it is a case of imperfect competition. So there is no perfect competition characteristics are work, so it is called imperfect. Monopoly, duopoly, oligopoly, etc. are its markets. What are monopoly, what are duopoly, that we are discussing next chapter of fifth, that is market. But as per this, due to decrease in the price, average revenue curve slopes down from left to right. Here price are not remain change, not remain constant, not remain as perfect competitive market, but price are going down. And so if the price going down, revenue are down, average revenue also down. So left to right. Now here some summarize or revision. Professor Marshall says the factors of the production face this real cost, and to attract them, return is given in the form of dash dash and dash, that is wages, interest and profit. The concept of opportunity cost was properly presented by Marshall. Austrian are given the concept of, but properly represented by Marshall, very very important this one. Concept of monetary cost is useful in economic analysis. Raw material, etc., labor or fuel are variable. Why? Because it is change in short term, so it is variable. Next, a dash is such a period in which a producer cannot change the size of firm but can increase production, that is short term. In long run it not possible. A dash is a period in which producer can change all the factors of production, that is long term. In long term all the factors of production are dash, variable. In short periods either production dash dash or dash, increase decrease remains zero. Fixed cost is also known as a overhead cost, very important. Dash is also known as a total fixed cost, that is fixed cost. Total fixed cost curve is dash to axis, this is parallel to x axis, very very important. When cost incurred on variables factors by producer is called, that is variable cost. In variable cost, cost increases as dash increase, production increase. Variable cost is also known as a dash and dash and dash dash, unstable or direct or main cost. MCQs. Variable cost has dash relation with quantity of production, direct positive. Why? Because production increase, variable also increase. In short term, fixed cost is fixed but dash keeps changing, variable cost. The sum of the total fixed cost and total variable cost is equal to dash total cost. TC and TVC are dash to each other, parallel, very important. TVC equal to what? Average variable cost. Marginal cost decrease more rapidly than average cost. According to dash is long run, there is no distinction between the fixed and variable cost. There has been harm, very important. If total revenue is lower than the total cost, dash occur, losses occur. So it is very important information for you all. Some of the diagram is also there, so we are going with some of the other diagram for this chapter. So stay with slightly. I am asking you some questions regarding this. What are the formula of marginal revenue? What are the formula of average revenue? What are the formula of fixed average fixed cost? These all are very important. So now we slightly revise this all, and we can see so many points. If there is some remaining part in for this chapter, so here some animated touch are also requirement for this. So very repeatedly we are going to start with this. Cost of production, price of goods which determined by the sum of the cost are resources, cost, revenue and profit. Here the introduction points are there, that we discuss what is production, what is firm, what is credit. This all are discussed. Various concept of cost. There are three costs: real, opportunity and monetary cost. Then the definition of real cost and non-material cost. Opportunity cost, you study late night for a final, the next day you are very sleepy, your opportunity cost is good night by sleep. To work all day and make some money, to take the day off and go to movie, this is opportunity cost. These are the picture of factors one use, factors having unrealized opportunity cost, monetary cost. Definition of these two, very very important. The cost of production in terms of money is known as a monetary cost. Short term periods we discuss, Then long term period we discuss. There are so many classifications we find out in this short run and production cost classification about fixed cost. This is the diagram we can find out. You can see here fixed cost are always fixed at any level of production, quantity of unit whatever, here 10, 20, 30, 40, whatever, but fixed cost is parallel to x-axis. Variable cost is always in positive mode. If production is 1, cost 10, 2, 20, 3, 30, 4, 40, 5, 50, so it is in positive mode. And if the production are 0, then cost is also 0. Total cost, average cost, you can see the average cost curve is in U shape. That is why, because average cost, average fixed cost equal to fixed cost divided by total cost. So average fixed cost curve is like this. Average variable cost is also in U shape. Average variable cost equal to variable cost by total production. So output are always on X and cost are always on Y. So with the help of this, we can find out in U shape this mode. Average total cost is also same curve as like as average variable cost, but here total cost are together fixed and variable cost. So average cost equal to what? That is total cost by total production, and total cost including with fixed and variable. So it is a U-shaped mode of average total cost or average cost. Average cost is also known as average total cost. Now marginal cost. Here we can find out quantity and cost. Marginal cost, if addition of extra unit of production, the cost are also increased. So difference between total cost, that is called marginal cost. Relationship we can find out. Then concept of revenue, total revenue, it is depend on these two factors, total sold unit and price of unit. Then average revenue, total revenue divided by unit sold, margin revenue, use of concept of revenue and cost. Here the equilibrium of the form, it is not part of curriculum, but we can find out the marginal cost and average cost. Sometimes average cost is, average cost curve you can find out is higher than marginal cost. Here from this point of view we can find out the average cost is more than marginal cost, but in this time we can see it is lower than marginal cost, and sometimes it is equal to. So relationship between AC and MC is MC more than AC, MC equal to AC, and MC less than AC. So I am very thankful to all of you that you see till the end of this, and you are now giving some of the answer after this all concept. I hope you clear in your mind. So first question is that what is real cost? Second is give the formula of marginal cost, and what are the relationship between average cost and marginal cost. So I am very thankful to you, and we are ready for the next chapter from next time. So have a good day. Thank you. Take care. I hope you enjoy this session and you can get some new techniques.